क्वेश्चन नंबर 51। विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग पेयर्स इज करेक्टली मैच्ड? ऑप्शन ए इन इंडिया कंसिडरेशन मस्ट फॉलो फ्रॉम द प्रोमिसी ओनली, बी इन इंडिया कंसिडरेशन मस्ट फॉलो फ्रॉम ओनली प्रोमिसर और ओनली प्रोमिसी, सी इन इंडिया कंसिडरेशन मस्ट फॉलो फ्रॉम द प्रोमिसर और एनी अदर पर्सन, डी इन इंडिया कंसिडरेशन मस्ट फॉलो प्रोमिसी और एनी अदर पर्सन। हेयर करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन डी, इन इंडिया कंसिडरेशन मस्ट फॉलो प्रोमिसी और एनी अदर पर्सन। क्वेश्चन नंबर 52। विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स रिगार्डिंग कंसिडरेशन इज नॉट करेक्ट? Here options are, it must be given at the desire of the promisor, B, it may be passed also, it need not be adequate to the promise, stranger to it cannot sue. Here in question number 52, correct answer is option D. This is not correct, other options are correct. Question number 53, which one of the following is not essential for a consideration? Option A, it must be given at the desire of the promisor, valuable, lawful, adequate. Here correct answer is option D. Option D here is the right answer. It is not an essential of consideration. Other given options are the essential for consideration. Question number 54. Consider the following statements. Performance of a legal duty is no consideration for a promise. Forbearance to sue has always been regarded as valuable consideration. It is not necessary that consideration should be adequate to the promise. Which of the following statement is our correct? Option A, one only. Option B, two and three. Option C, one, two and three. And option D, one and two. Here correct answer is option C, that is 1, 2 and 3. All the statements here are the correct statements. Question number 55. An agreement entered into with free consent and lawful but with inadequate consideration is option A unlawful, option B lawful, option C void and option D voidable. Here correct answer is option B, that is lawful. Question number 56. According to the, consider the following statements. According to Justice Patterson, consideration may be some benefit to the plaintiff or some determinant to the defendant. Second statement, according to section 2D of the Indian Contract Act, the definition of consideration requires that the act or absence should be done by promisee only. Which of the following statements given above is are correct? Here in question number 56, statement 1 only is correct. Therefore, here right answer is 1 only, option A. Question number 57. A promises to provide maintenance allowance to her maternal uncle in consideration of a certain properties gifted to her by her mother. A refuses to pay maintenance amount and maternal uncle institutes suit against A to enforce the promise. Which one of the following is a correct statement? Maternal uncle option A will not succeed as he being a stranger to the consideration cannot sue upon the contract. B will succeed because according to the Indian Contract Act, consideration may be given by the promisee or any other person. C will succeed because he is near relative and in such cases consideration is not necessary. D will succeed because consideration given by a near relation may be treated as consideration given by the promisee. Here in question number 57, correct answer is option B. He will succeed because according to the Indian Contract Act, consideration may be given by the promisee or any other person. Question number 58. A, without the request of anybody, extinguishes the fire of B's go down. A suffers injury thereby. If B promises to compensate A for the whole amount he has spent for his treatment, then the contract is unenforceable because it is immoral, void for want of consideration, voidable, enforceable. Here, in question number 58, correct answer is option D, that is enforceable. Question number 59. Every promise and every set of promise forming the consideration for each other is option A, an agreement, an acceptance, an offer, a contract. Correct answer here is option A, that is an agreement. Question number 60. An agreement not enforceable by law is said to be option A, void, option B, voidable contract, option C, legal contract, and option D, quasi-contract. Correct answer here is option C. An agreement not enforceable by law is said to be illegal contract. Question number 61. A void agreement means agreement not enforceable by law, agreement illegal in nature, agreement not enforceable in a court of law, agreement violating legal procedure. Here, correct answer is option A. A void agreement means agreement not enforceable by law. Question number 62. Choose the correct statement. Option A. An agreement not enforceable by law is said to be void. An agreement enforceable at the option of one party and not at the option of the other is said to be void. An agreement which is legal may be void. An agreement enforceable at the option of one party is void. Here correct answer is option A. An agreement not enforceable by law is said to be void. ऑप्शन ए हेयर इज द करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 63. एन एग्रीमेंट नॉट इन्फोर्सेबल बाय लॉ इज सेड टू बी वॉइड अंडर ऑप्शन ए सेक्शन 2D, ऑप्शन बी सेक्शन 2E, ऑप्शन सी सेक्शन 2F एंड ऑप्शन डी सेक्शन 2G. हेयर करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन डी, दैट इज सेक्शन 2G. एन एग्रीमेंट नॉट इन्फोर्सेबल बाय लॉ सेड टू बी वॉइड अंडर सेक्शन 2G. क्वेश्चन नंबर 64. For an acceptance, mere mental resolve to accept would not be sufficient. There must be some external manifestation of the intent by speech, writing, or the other act. It was held by the Supreme Court in Fazal Ilahi versus East Indian Railway Company, M. Nanjappa versus M.P. Muthuswamy, Dugdale versus Lowering, Bhagwan Das versus Girdhari Lal and Company. In question number 64, correct answer is option D, Bhagwan Das versus Girdhari Lal and Company. Question number 65. The Indian Contract Act defines contract in section. Here, correct answer is option D, that is section 2H. Section 2H of the Indian Contract Act defines the term contract. Question number 66. Which of the following ingredients is not necessary for contract? Option A, proposal. Option B, acceptance. Option C, consideration. And option D, property. Here, property is not the essential or the necessity to form a contract. Therefore, option D here will be the right answer. Because in this question it has been asked which of the following is not necessary for contract. Property is not necessary for contract, whereas proposal, acceptance and consideration are the essential ingredients for the formation of contract. Question number 67. Which of the following is correct? A contract may be oral, must be in writing, must be made in the presence of a witness, must be written on a stamp paper. Here correct answer is option A, that is may be oral. A contract may be oral as well as written also. Here in the given option, correct answer will be, or the accurate answer will be option A, a contract may be oral, because it is not necessary that it must be in writing, and also it is not necessary that it has to be made in the presence of witness, and also it is not essential that it should be written on a stamp paper. Therefore, in the given option, correct answer is option A, that is may be oral. Question number 68. In the formation of a contract, which is not among the three essentials? Option A, damages. Option B, consideration. Option C, offer. And option D, acceptance. Here correct answer is option A, that is damages. Question number 69. According to section 2H of the Indian Contract Act, a contract is option A, an agreement between two or more parties, a promise to do something, an acceptance of an order, an agreement enforceable by law. Here correct answer is option D. In section 2H, the definition of contract is given, and which suggests that the contract is an agreement enforceable by law. Question number 70. An agreement enforceable by law at the instance of one or more of the parties and not of other or others under section 2I of the Indian Contract Act is called option A, a valid contract. Option B, an illegal contract. Option C, a void contract. And option D, avoidable contract. Here correct answer is option D, that is avoidable contract. Question number 71. A contract which is valid initially, however, ceases to be enforceable subsequently. The contract remains valid, becomes voidable when it ceases to be enforceable, becomes void when it ceases to be enforceable, becomes void since inception. Here in question number 71, correct answer is option C, that is becomes void when it ceases to be enforceable. Question number 72. Which of the following statement is correct? A voidable contract is an agreement which is enforceable with the permission of the court, enforceable by the parties thereto, enforceable by law at the option of one or more of the parties thereto, but not at the option of the other or others, not enforceable by any of the parties thereto. Here in question number 72, correct answer is option C. A voidable contract is an agreement which is enforceable by law at the option of the one or more of the parties thereto, but not at the option of the other. Question number 73. Privity of contract is that the parties to the contract can sue each other. Beneficiary to the contract can sue the parties. Parties to the contract can sue the third party, both B and C. In question number 73, correct answer is option A. Privity of contract is that the parties to the contract can sue each other. Question number 74. A stranger to a contract cannot enforce the contract. Reason, he is not a party to a contract, cannot take benefit. Here, option A is both A and R both are true, and R is the correct explanation of A. B, A and R both are true, but R is not the correct explanation of A. C, A is true, but R is false. And D, A is false, but R is true. In question number 74, the correct answer is option A, that is A and R both are true, but R is the correct explanation of A. Question number 75. The doctrine of privity of contract means that a contract is a private affair between the parties. Consideration can be supplied only by the parties to the contract. The contract can be enforced only by civil and private action. Only parties to the contract can sue and be sued upon the contract. Here, correct answer is option D. Only parties to contract can sue and be sued upon the contract.